just because one person never collapse, everybody collapse. Is it worth it? Is it worth the price? So I think that one way out is because of the failure of one NDB and the discrepancy of 2.13 billion. Up to now, no explanation. What's the discrepancy of that 2.13 billion between the price of sale for Bandar Malaysia announced by the Chinese company in Hong Kong, and that was that announced by one NDB in Kuala Lumpur? What is the difference? So that we know full explanation. I think it's very important that they must come clean. The fact is that they failed to come clean. And if you want to revive confidence, I think investors are looking at your investments not just in real estate alone. They are looking at on fundamental factors. Spend money not on building new underground cities. Spend money on education. Spend money on infrastructure and public transport. Spend money on innovation. Spend money on creating high income employment for Malaysians. As I said just now, when you talk about employing Malaysian workers, we spend 55% more. So instead of getting 30 million ringgit profit, we end up only having 3 million ringgit profit for MPFP. But we are willing to spend that money. Why? Because we want to give employment to Malaysians. Why should we be giving employment to foreign workers? So will they be able to adopt the Penang approach? We have no GST. And do you think that because there's no GST, Penang needs to be safe? No GST, we still can record budget surpluses. He has GST, he still record budget deficits. So what is the logic? Where is the logic? We record budget surpluses even without GST. And he still record budget deficit with GST. So tak masuk akal. So saya rasa yang perkara pokok ni ialah, adakah anda menjalankan kerajaan atau tata kelola yang bersih? Kalau bersih, tak perlu GST pun masih boleh untung, BRIN pun boleh bagi. Nah, kita telah buktikan dekat Pulau Pinang, kita masih berikan bantuan dari segi warga emas, anak emas, pelajar emas, mahasiswa emas, semua emas masuk. Ini kita masih bagi, semua pun tak ada GST langsung. Semua pun tak dapat wang daripada pihak kerajaan pusat. 2% saja kita dapat balik, 63 bilion kita ringgit kita bayar, dapat balik 2%, tapi kita masih boleh tak bertahan lagi. Kerana kita amalkan pentadbiran bersih. So saya rasa apa gunanya sebarang revision bajet kalau tak ada pentadbiran bersih. Jangan-jangan hanya indah khabar dari rumah.